Crab feasts will continue like they always do in Maryland, but this summer it could be more expensive.
I think it's very much a mixed bag with the data. And unfortunately, blue crabs tend to do this to us very often. They send us kind of mixed signals. So
Chris Moore, senior scientist with the Chesapeake Bay Foundation, says the data found in a recent blue crab report are both troubling and promising.
The bad news is the number of juveniles was the lowest on record. And obviously, we never want to see a population that's at the lowest on record. And the number of males dropped pretty significantly as well.
But when it comes to female crabs, things are looking better. While female spawning age crabs dropped year over year from 158 million to 141 million, that's still above the long-term average of 126 million. Still, total estimated crabs in the bay dropped dramatically year over year from 405 million to 282 million.
It doesn't bode well for later on this summer or next year in the springtime.
Blair Baltus, president of the Baltimore County Watermen's Association, is trying to find a silver lining.
The mature female crabs, the last year we've been pretty good in the numbers where you know, it should be sustainable, and it's all probably weather related.
While he says the female numbers look good, next season will most likely depend on water salinity and if tropical storms and hurricanes can help push more larvae back into the bay.
We could bounce back next winter and have a great juvenile count on the crabs if we get the right conditions with them.
So overall, again, just to recap, that summer crab feast is likely to cost a little more this year than it did last year. If you'd like to take a closer look at that survey, we have a link on our website, WBAL-TV.com, and on our mobile app. We're live in Canton tonight. I'm Lowell Melser, WBAL-TV 11 News.